We're going to encounter various functions in calculus, so let's start to review them. Let's start with polynomials and rational functions. So a polynomial function of degree n looks like f of x equals a naught plus a1x plus a2x squared, etc., up to the last power of x, which will be n, so a sub n x to the n. And if the polynomial is of degree n, then this a sub n cannot be equal to zero. The domain of a polynomial function is always the entire real line, so it's R. There's an important theorem in mathematics that's called the fundamental theorem of algebra. Fundamental theorem of algebra. In calculus, we'll learn the fundamental theorem of calculus, but before calculus was invented, there was already a fundamental theorem of algebra. What that says is that the nth degree polynomial equation has n complex roots. Okay? Remember that a real number is a subset of the real numbers are a subset of the complex numbers. So a real root is also considered a complex root. So if it has a x to the nth power here, it should have n complex roots. There's a provision to this in that we have to count the multiplicity of each root. But I'll show you what that means through an example. So the example I want to look at is the quadratic equation. So f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c. So that's the quadratic polynomial. So what are the roots of the quadratic polynomial? Well, that's given by the quadratic formula. So we know that the roots are x plus or minus is negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, everybody should know this from their high school. So there are three cases to consider here, depending on the sign of b squared minus 4ac. So the first case is when b squared minus 4ac is positive, then we have two real roots, right? We have plus or minus the square root of a positive number. So this case has two real roots. Then the second case is when b squared minus 4ac is negative. Then this is the square root of a negative number. So that becomes I times the square root of 4ac minus b squared. So it would be plus or minus I. So in this case, there are also two roots, but they're complex and they are complex conjugates. So this case has complex conjugate roots. Then there's the third case. So the third case is when b squared minus 4ac equals zero. In that case, there's only one root. So there's one real root. And you may say, well, then don't we violate the fundamental theorem of algebra? But that's the special case where we say that the root has multiplicity two. So it's one real root with multiplicity two. And what do we mean by multiplicity two? It means if we factor the quadratic ax squared plus bx plus c, we would get a factor. So the root is negative b over 2a. So it should factor as x plus b over 2a, and it will be squared. And that square in the exponent means that the root comes with a multiplicity 2. So provided we include this provision, then the fundamental theorem of algebra holds for the quadratic equation, and in fact it holds for all polynomials, functions of degree n. Okay, let's look at rational functions then. So what is a rational function? A rational function is a function that is the division of two polynomials. So we can write a rational function f of x as the numerator is a polynomial. So we can write it as a naught plus a one x plus dot 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 plus a sub m x to the m, say. And the denominator is also a polynomial. So we could write it as b naught plus b1x plus dot, 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 plus, and then the order of the polynomial can be different. So I can write it as b sub n times x to the n. So the numerator then is a polynomial of order of degree m, and the denominator is a polynomial of degree n. What is the domain here? So the domain would again be all the real numbers, except we would have to exclude all the values of x where the denominator is zero. You're not allowed to divide by zero. So minus the real roots of the denominator. Okay, so the difficulty of the rational function then is that for some values of x, we could possibly be dividing by zero. Here's an example, a very simple example. We can take f of x equals 1 divided by 1 minus x. That's a rational function. The numerator is the constant polynomial. The denominator is the linear polynomial, 1 minus x. The domain of this function then is the all the real numbers, except for x equals 1, where the denominator is 0. Let me summarize. I'm introducing now, or reviewing probably for you, two types of functions, the polynomial functions and the rational functions. The polynomial function can be up to degree n, meaning that it has a term a sub n x to the n, where a sub n is not equal to 0. The domain is the whole real numbers. And the rational function then is the division of two polynomial functions. Its domain is the entire real numbers, excluding the real roots of the denominator. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.